Joining me right now is Jason Poney. He'll be fighting at Hex Fight Series 15 in the main event versus BJ Bland on July 21st in Perth. What's happening, Jason?
Hey guys, how are you? I'm good, me. I'm good. I'm in Celtic Gym now. All is good now. Yeah.
All right, I want to go back to last year, Jason. You returned to this side of the world. You went to FMD. You took on UFC veteran Tommy Haydn. You destroyed him, took his lightweight title. How fun is it to fight for Full Metal Dojo?
Full Metal Dojo is a very funny organization, you know? Very funny. But the level of competition is high. But it's a good experience, you know, for fighter to fight here. Because of the rules. Because the rules is like... with soccer kicks, with elbows, with all the kind of mixed martial arts rules. And the ambience too, because yes, John Nutt, the owner, the CEO of the Full Metal Dojo is a crazy guy. So it's good to fight there sometime.
Yeah, the rule is there is no rules.
Yeah. Yeah, at the meeting he always... make me laugh every time because he keep telling that it's crazy. After all, it's a normal MMA, you know, normal MMA, but the atmosphere, you know, the atmosphere is like you fight in a garage, you know, or something like this. It's funny.
You won the fight with multiple soccer kicks. It's, you know, I watched it live, so I was screaming like it was the craziest thing, because Tommy Haydn, he's very well respected in the country, you know, around this area, and you took him out pretty easily. Did you expect to beat him the way you did?
I was prepared for him, you know, because I knew he was like a very good wrestler, so I wrestled a lot. So I was very, very confident. I was thinking he will slow down at the second round. It comes earlier, so it's good for me. But I was prepared, man. I was prepared, and I want it so bad, you know. I wanted to take the victory so bad. So I go all in, man. That was good.
Is there any plans for a title defense in FMD this year?
I told the FMD guy anytime. When they find me someone, I go back. And you know, I know Tommy wants to fight me again, but I think before to fight me again, he have to have at least one win, you know. And after, if he won one fight, he can come back anytime. I will be there. But yes, for the Full Metal Dojo, I heard they're gonna make it maybe September, I think.
Yes.
September or October, yeah. So I asked them already to fight on the card. So let's see if they find someone for me. And after I beat again Tommy.
All right.
It's for Tommy Haydn. It's for you, Tommy. I beat you again.
You joined the MMA team at Fairtex Training Center in Pattaya. How did you hook up with them?
Long story. Actually, I have my cousin here who is fighting in Muay Thai for the team. He, Fabrice Delano. He just fight in, not this one, but the 1FC in Macau. Okay. The 1FC in Macau. So he was the first who he was always telling me about, how do you say that? Talk me about the Fairtex. He told me, yes, come to Fairtex. It's good. They want to build a new MMA team. So yes, one day I come to see, and I see the atmosphere was good and the training was good. So I stay. So why? That's why.
After you joined the team, you took a fight last April. 2 days' notice at ACB 85. You took on Dolton Santos. You lost by majority decision. What did you take away from that, you know, fight?
Yeah, I take this fight first. I take this fight because you know, it's a big opportunity to fight. I think for me, ACB is one of the top league today. So I take the opportunity, even 2 days notice, because I want to go in a bigger stage. You know, big stage, like, yes, for me, ACB, ONE FC, Bellator, after, of course, UFC, you know, the top organization. I take this fight. I go. I do my thing. It was a very technical and strategical fight, I think. And unfortunately, I lost. But it was a good fight, you know, because I learned a lot. Because the guy was stronger than me, physically stronger than me. So maybe, yeah. First, I think no more 77 fight because I'm natural 70. And after, yeah, you have to be ready more than I was ready, you know.
All right, now you got a fight coming up on Hex 15. This is also on short notice, only a few weeks. Is it mentally better to take fights with little time to think about your opponent?
I think when you are, you know, I have a lot of fights now under my belt, like 30 fights, I think, something like this. I think when you have little bit experience, you can take that kind of fight, because especially when you are in Thailand and you are training like three times a day, you are ready, you know. Most of the time, fighters don't take fights like this because it's in the head, you know. They are like, oh no, maybe this time I don't have the time to plan, to do my game plan, blah, blah, blah. But after all, it's a fight, you know. Anything can happen. Sorry, my English is not so good. But after all, fight is a fight, you know. You know you are. It's like your job, you know. You every day I get up, I go training the morning, evening, every day. So I'm ready. So that's why I take that kind of fight.
When they came to you with the fight, and you heard the name BJ Bland, did you know anything about him?
Not really. But as I told you, I know X Series is a very good organization, you know, because I train with some guys there. What's his name? Aldin Bates. Aldin Bates.
Yeah. Yes.
A big welterweight guy.
Yeah.
Yeah. I trained with him and he told me he was a fighter there. So I take a look after, and then I saw the level. So to fight in that kind of event is good for me, I think. But BJ Blaine, no, I don't know him that much, you know. But I know because after I check on the Sherdog and I saw he looks very, very strong, well-rounded, but as I told you, after all, we are ready every time for anything. So let's go.
In the short amount of time that you have, what have you been focusing on? Is there certain things, like you said that you have so much experience now that you could just go into a fight? So with the little bit of time you have, do you switch something on, or is it just regular? You just go with the regular schedule.
No, I do. Like usual, you know, because as he's well rounded, you know, I cannot say like, okay, I focus on that or I focus on that, because he's like well rounded, so he can do anything. So I have to do the same, you know. This fight will be a real MMA fight, you know, with all the area of MMA, you know, stand up, grappling, wrestling. So I train a little bit all, so yes, I will be ready for that, because I like that kind of fight, you know.
On July 21st, how do you see this fight going? Do you just see a fight that's going to go the whole three rounds, or do you see something quick that you're going to take advantage of and finish him?
For sure, I will try to finish him before the end bell, for sure. One first round, second round, or third round. I try as hard I can, you know. But after, you know, he's an experienced guy too, so maybe if I cannot knock him out or take him out before the bell, it will be a decision. But I hope no. I hope I finish the fight before. and I give all, you know, in this way, you know, to finish the fight before, you know. Even if it's technical fight or strategical fight, I will always be looking for an opening.
Is this your first trip to Australia?
Yes, it's my first trip. First time in Australia. Yes, it's my first time. I a little bit exciting about it because to see another country like this, so big and so different, I think can be good.
All right, July 21st in Perth, Hex Fight Series 15 main event. Jason Poney will face BJ Bland. Thank you for your time, Jason, and good luck on your fight, man.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. And again, because I know Tommy Aiden called me out, so again for Tommy, win one round, one fight, and after I take you again. All right, bye-bye.
Bye.